Yes, everybody, how are you all doing? Welcome back to my channel, and this is the Trifox X16 QR review. Let's get into it. Right, before I do this review, I just want to talk about how important a bike fit is, and it's something I recommend you do. There's a website which I've gone to. It worked out all my calculations, like my inseam length, my arm length, and actually turned out my legs are longer than my arms, so, you know. But yeah, I'll put a link down in the description. It's not sponsored at all, but it's something I would recommend you doing, because if you don't get a proper bike fit, you're going to get neck pain, ankle pain, numbness in your wrists, all that kind of stuff. So yeah, I would definitely recommend getting a bike fit if you're going to get any kind of frame or anything like that. Right, so first I'm going to start with the positives. Positive number one, this frame costs $649. So yeah, that's actually a really cheap price. I don't think you can find any cheaper, to be fair. Maybe on AliExpress, but $649 for a carbon frame is pretty, pretty good. Positive number two, this frame is super, super lightweight. It's crazy. So I think I weighed it in a previous video. I'll put a link in the title around here somewhere. And it weighed just over 6 kilos, which is just absolutely insane. That's how light it is. But yeah, you can watch that video in the link around here. Positive number three, it's really easy to build. I didn't find any sharp edges anywhere. No sharp edges around the headset, around the bottom bracket. And yeah, it was just really easy to build and put together. Positive number four, because the frame is so light, it's so fast. It's actually scary how fast it is. Yeah, it's just really, really fast. It's kind of like a sports car. Just imagine a sports car trugging along in gear one and it just wants to go into gear five and just fly. That's exactly what this frame feels like. It just wants to go. Like, you just put your foot on the pedal and that's it. You're just cruising, absolutely cruising. It's so fast, but because it is so light. But yeah, it's super fast. Positive number five. It's really nice paintwork. I think I got the hollow painted one. I can't really remember now which name it was. But yeah, it looks really similar to an SL6, SL7, but yeah, really nice paintwork. It's almost got that reflective rainbow colour to it, but yeah, I really like the paintwork on it. Positive number six, you can use this on all electronic group sets, DI2, SRAM Force, which I'm currently running at the minute. Yeah, compatible with all electronic group sets. Positive number seven, this frame is really comfortable to ride. Even when I'm going to 50 kilometers plus, it just feels really nice. It's not overly stiff, which is a good thing, but that's going to lead me onto my negatives. So when I talk about stiffness, some people think that might be a negative thing or a positive thing. But yeah, I'm going to go into my negatives now, and then you can make up your own mind if it's a positive or negative. So the negatives of the frame. Like I said in my previous point, some people might find this a negative thing. Some people might find it a positive thing. So the frame is not overly stiff. But for me, that's not a negative thing, but that might be a negative thing for some people. So I found when it comes to really stiff frames and stuff like that, when you get to like 25 kilometers, it gets really uncomfortable and it's like you're riding a brick. I don't like overly stiff bikes. But again, so some people might find that positive, some people might find that a negative. So yeah, when I mean by not overly stiff, the forks have got a bit of flex to them, as does where the rear wheel attaches as well. There's just a bit of flex in there. But for me, that's not a negative. Some people might find that a negative. Negative number two. Because this frame is an aero, this is nothing negative towards Trifox. This is just the way the frame's designed. Because it's not an aero frame, you can really feel those crosswinds. Because where I live in the East Midlands. And it's quite hilly, there's a lot of crosswinds, and because the frame is so light, you can really feel when those winds just kind of hit you from the side, and you're like, whoa, hang about. you don't lose control, but you just kind of really feel those crosswinds when they come at you. But Trifox do an aero frame, so if you are looking to get an aero frame, maybe look into that one. Negative number three. This really isn't a negative, and it's not aimed at Trifox in any way. It's just an issue what I found when I was building it. They include a headset clamp, but the thing is, the headset clamp is quite short. And I needed, when I did my online bike fit, it said that I needed like 30 mil of spacers. So I just had to go out and buy a headset clamp, which was slightly longer. because the fork wasn't sitting flush. And I was like, for ages, like, why is it not sitting flush? But then all I had to do was just get a longer headset clamp. So if you are thinking about getting this frame and using quite a lot of spacers, just make sure that you get a longer headset clamp, just so it just secures everything in place. Negative number four. Again, this isn't really aimed at Trifox, it's more the shipping company. So when I put my bike together, I was trying to index the whole gears, get everything set up properly, and it took me a while to realise that the rear mech hanger was bent. Wasn't a big issue, but it was a bit annoying when I put everything together and tried to set everything up. But then I contacted Trifox, they sent me a new one straight away. Excuse me. So that's not a bad thing. But yeah, like I said, it was just more the shipping company. So Trifox or any other companies, really, if you're watching, just detach the rear mech hanger so you're not going to run into that issue of it possibly being bent just from shipping. So for me, there isn't a lot of negatives really on this frame. But there is this amazing YouTuber called Trace Velo. And I'm going to put a link down in the description to the video because he actually had a build issue with his Trifox frame. And I'm also going to show you a bit of the clip now as well.
It still wobbles around all over the place. With the front derailleur removed, you can see three of the four rivets that hold the hanger onto the frame have come loose, and presumably the fourth one isn't far behind either.
So that was the clip there. So as you could see, he was having issues on his front derailleur hanger after like 300 kilometers or so. I think it was just really important to note that out, because I feel like a lot of the Chinese companies, when they're building the frames, all they do is just mold the frames, paint them, and then them ship them out. I don't think there's a lot of checks what go on after they're actually built. They just build them, then ship them. And I think that's another reason why the costs are managed to be as low as what they are, because of these certain factors. So if you are thinking about buying a Trifox or any kind of Chinese carbon frame from any manufacturer, just kind of keep that in mind, that I don't think that they do a lot of checks afterwards. I've also seen a lot of YouTube videos as well on other Chinese brands where there's like extra paint or extra carbon where they've had to get a file and kind of file down the paint, file down a bit of carbon so parts and stuff fit properly. So yeah, just keep that in mind if you are thinking about buying a Chinese frame, that they don't do a lot of checks and stuff afterwards. But then you've also got that point of that it is cheaper because they don't do those checks and stuff. So would I recommend this frame? The answer is yes, resounding yes. It's super light, super fast, super cheap. I couldn't recommend it enough, especially if you're on a bit of a budget. So on the next scene, I'm going to score this frame out of 10. But before I go, do me a favour, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and hit that like button. Did I do that right? Yeah, I did. So much going on. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video.